A quick disclaimer for you guys, this is a much more serious toned video game top 10. I just wanted to let you guys know that ahead. We are going to talk about crime, violence, murder, and other things in this video. So I just wanted to give you a heads up. We hear about it all the time. Do video games lead to real life violence? Well, the answer to that question is a hard no, but that is not to say that it's never happened. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we're going to go on a serious note here for today. We're going to be taking a look at 10 video games that actually did lead to real life violence. Now, this is a disclaimer, since I know this is a very touchy subject. This video is not at all suggesting that I believe video games lead to violence, because I definitely do not. This video is simply to showcase 10 times that someone has been influenced by a game to commit a terrible crime. Even though if that's not the actual game's fault, this was their excuse or their precedent, okay? Now that we've gotten that all out of the way, let's get started. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Good luck on the giveaway, guys, and now let's go over 10 video games that have led to real life violence at some point. Kicking off our list at number 10 is EverQuest. In October of 2017, a woman named Liz Woolley was shocked to find that her son, Sean, had passed away at his desk from a self-inflicted gunshot. Now, according to Liz, Sean killed himself because of EverQuest, which was a huge MMO that was released in 99. And according to her, he took his life because of the game, and that's how strong the game is. You can't just get up and walk away from the game. Despite the fact that Sean reportedly had other issues in life, his mother blames EverQuest entirely for his suicide. And as a distraught mother, I can't put myself in her shoes. I've never been in that situation. It would be very, very easy to find something like that to blame. At number 9, and this game makes a lot of our controversial top 10s here, okay? One of the reasons why it's remembered for its violence in this is this particular case we're going to talk about in 2004, and we are talking about Manhunt. A 17-year-old named Warren LeBlanc lured his friend, a 14-year-old named Stephen Packery, out into a remote area of Stokeswood Park in the UK, all right? According to LeBlanc, Packery owed him £75, which he was going to try and get out of him. Although, the exchange ultimately led to LeBlanc brutally beating his friend to death with a claw hammer. Now, according to LeBlanc's parents, he was an avid Manhunt player, and as the case following the murder, the judge ruled that LeBlanc was guilty and that the game had nothing to do with it. But this did not stop Dixons, one of the biggest retailers in the UK, to pull all the copies of Manhunt at that time from their shelves due to all the negative attention that it was garnering. At number 8, we have Mortal Kombat. As if this series wasn't controversial enough, there was a case in 2007 that only made things more complicated for Midway Games, the owners of this franchise. In December of 2007, a 7-year-old girl was murdered by Lamar Roberts, a 17-year-old boy, and his girlfriend, Heather Trujillo. According to the reports, the two were avid Mortal Kombat players, and they were trying to replicate the moves in the game. Both of them were found guilty, and Heather was sentenced to 18 years in prison, while Lamar was sentenced to 36. I'm not sure why Lamar got twice as long of a sentence, but at least their crimes aren't going unpunished. At number 7, we have Dota. Still super popular game, and in 2014 in the Philippines, a 17-year-old boy was reportedly picked up by his grandmother from an internet cafe where he had been playing Dota. His grandmother had apparently interrupted his game, which sent him into a rage and allegedly led to him killing the 68-year-old woman once they actually got home. According to reports, the 17-year-old did not remember the event and said that he blacked out completely after he had murdered her. He was taken into custody, and I think, now he actually lives with social workers. I don't know. I mean, pretty easy excuse to say you blacked out, and I don't... You can get mad at a game, but you can't take it to that extreme. At number 6, Grand Theft Auto 4. In August of 2008, in Thailand, a 54-year-old taxi driver named Quan Pokang was stabbed to death by a 19-year-old boy named Polat Chino. According to the reports, Polat had ridden in the cab, and after being asked to pay for his fare, which is a normal thing, right? He instead stabbed him to death and attempted to drive off after moving the body to the back seat and taking over the wheel. However, he was quickly caught since he didn't know how to drive at all, and Polat was reportedly addicted to Grand Theft Auto 4, and after being arrested, he told the police that killing seemed easy in the game. At number 5, you're not going to believe this one, but hey, here we go. Farmville. In January of 2010, a 22-year-old woman named Alexandria Tobias was arrested for killing her 3-month-old child. Now, according to reports, Alexandria was playing Farmville, and her young son interrupted her by crying, causing the mother to grow very angry, pick up the baby, and start shaking him, leading to him getting hit in the head and passing away. Now, Alexandria called 911, tried to blame the dog for the death of her son, although she later confessed the truth, leading to her being sentenced to 50 years in prison. As far as I'm concerned, she should stay in prison until she passes away. That's insane. That is absolutely an insane story. At number 4, a movie tie-in game in the form of Scarface The World Is Yours that was released in 2006, and it's actually a pretty good game. As opposed to many of the terrible movie tie-in games that get released nowadays, this one wasn't too bad. Unfortunately, it also ended up being the cause of a terrible dispute, leading to a death. In June of 2007, a 22-year-old named Alejandro Garcia was playing the Scarface game with his cousins and reportedly got into an argument over whose turn it was to play. We've all been in this situation. Give up the controller, pass controller 1, and the argument got so intense and heated that Alejandro ended up shooting his cousin and killing him. Garcia was found guilty of murder and was sentenced to 15 to 30 years in prison for his actions. Fighting over whose turn it was to play at a video game. Going back to the Grand Theft Auto series at number 3, and this series has had its fair share of controversy since its inception, and this one is, I'm pretty sure, the biggest one to date. In June of 2008, a group of teenagers went out into their local town and decided to replicate the things that they would do in GTA 4. They robbed a man, smashing his teeth in the process, and they stole a woman's BMW. After being caught and arrested, they admitted that they were trying to live out their experiences that they had had with Rockstar's games, which led to a good amount of outrage, as you guys can probably imagine, in the world for that. But once again, people are responsible for their actions, okay? People are responsible for how they're influenced. I don't know. At number 2, and this isn't about a specific game, but rather a console, the PlayStation console. In November of 2010, a 16-year-old boy named Kendall Anderson was playing on his console, which he was a huge fan of. According to reports, him and his mother had gotten into an argument and she had taken his console away as punishment. I've done this. That night, Kendall snuck into his mom's room and bludgeoned her to death with a claw hammer. Then he tried to cremate her body in the oven, although he was unsuccessful and simply hid the body in an alley where it was found 2 days later. Kendall was arrested and obviously found guilty. And at number 1 today, we have Halo 3, one of the most successful games ever. Halo 3 was released in 2007 and sold millions upon millions of copies, and a 16-year-old boy named Daniel Petrick really wanted to get the game, but his parents did not allow him to own it. In order to still get it and play it, Daniel snuck out and managed to buy a copy of the game without his parents' knowledge. Eventually, his parents found out and also discovered he had been spending 18 hours a day on it, which obviously angered them and caused them to take it away from him, locking it in Daniel's father's lockbox. Daniel got the keys in the lockbox in an effort to get the game back, but also found a 9mm handgun, which he used to shoot both of his parents, killing his mom and wounding his father. Daniel was arrested, and at his hearing, his attorney tried to argue that his actions were because he was obsessed with the game, although the judge threw out these statements under the fact that Daniel was old enough to understand the concept of life and death, and that he knew exactly what he was doing when he did it. Daniel was sentenced to 23 years in prison, which he is still currently serving. There you have it, my friends. Those are 10 video games that did lead to real-life violence. Not necessarily because it was the video game's fault, but the video game was used as an excuse or stepping stone in the violence. Much more serious tone on this top 10. Let me know if you guys enjoy these or not. And there's a playlist below if you guys want to check out all the other video game top 10s. I put up a brand new one every single night at 8 o'clock Central Standard Time. And thank you to everybody that watches these videos every day. I'll see you tomorrow for a new one.